What's up, millennials? So I've been doing a little bit of research on an industry that I think is going to become huge this decade. Now, please hear me out. Drones. Now, I've done a little bit of research on YouTube, and it looks like not a lot of people are researching drone stocks just yet, which might be a very good signal for people like you and me, so the investors, because that might mean that we are still early. So in exchange for your time and hopefully a like as well, I'm going to give you some information about possibly some of the most important real-life use cases and also some specific drone companies that are public and that you can invest in. Today we're going to talk about four applications. First of all, passenger transportation. Secondly, military use. Then inspection. And fourth, package delivery. And for each of these four applications, I'm also going to give you some specific drone companies that you can look into. But before we get into the first application, if you would like to keep up to date with drone stocks, and also if you would like stock market news within 1 minute, then please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. All right, with that being said, let's get started. The first application that we are going to talk about today is, well, the robo-taxis, or the drones that are being used for passenger transportation. So of all the applications that I want to talk about today, I believe that this is like the least bullish one that I have, and the fourth one, so the last one, is probably the most bullish one of all the applications that we're going to talk about today. So in other words, in my opinion, this application, so the passenger transportation one, is also or has also got the smallest total addressable market, and the fourth is probably going to have the biggest total addressable market. So one of the drone stocks that you could invest in is Ehang, with ticker symbol EH. It's a Chinese company, so also if you want some exposure to the Chinese stocks, then this could be a company that you could invest your money in. Now, personally, I'm not very convinced about the use of big drones to transport passengers just yet, because I think in places, in big places like cities, autonomous cars are way easier to use. So like Tesla cars in the future would be way easier to use than these big drones. The thing is, I think that drones would simply occupy a lot of space in the air. And I can also imagine there would be some noise pollution as well, right? So people complaining about the noise that these big drones actually make. Now, I can see some drones being used between, for example, islands or something like that, places where it's very difficult for cars to go, or even impossible for cars to go to. But yeah, the problem is that you cannot really fit a lot of people inside a drone like this one. So I suppose that a boat could still be a little bit more useful than a big drone instead. Now, I can imagine these big drones being used for tourism, for example. So yeah, instead of using a helicopter or like a small plane or something like that, you could use a big drone like this to fly over beautiful places, right? Like fly over the nature or something like that. But again, it would just be a few people inside that drone. This drone is not going to carry like 30, 40, 50 people at the same time. And I also can't really imagine like hundreds of these big drones in the air at the same place at the same time as well. But yeah, who knows, maybe that is actually the reality in like 10 years time, right? So what do you think? Do you believe that passenger transportation and tourism with drones could actually be a big market during this decade? And then the second application would be military use. Now, here is where things become a little bit more practical, I would say. Drones in these cases, or cameras as we'll see as well, could be used for military surveillance and probably for attacks as well. So there are at least two public companies that are in this space, and no pun intended there. And these companies are AeroVironment, and that has ticker symbol AVAV, and Flir Systems with ticker symbol FLIR. Although Flir is actually more like an all-round company, because what they do is they are in the thermal camera industry. So yeah, these Flir products could actually be used across multiple segments. And if we then look at AeroVironment, we can see that they already have some drones that could be used in war zones, for example, right? Because these drones that you can see on the screen right now, they can do surveillance, for example, by putting just like a few cameras and a few heat sensors on the drones to see if there are any enemies around. And yeah, I can also imagine combining drones with weapons and missiles, for example, which could be used during attacks, right? And these drones could also be used for mapping purposes, for example. So basically to create a map of their surroundings so that they can know exactly what is around them, right? So what do you think? Do you agree with me that the military use is a little bit more investable than the transportation, the passenger transportation and tourism use? Then the third application would be inspection. And here is where I see many, many different specific use cases as well. Because inspection itself is still quite broad, right? And there, well, right now I would like to highlight two companies in this space. First of all, Parrot, and that has ticker symbol P-A-R-R-O. And a company called Ag Eagle with ticker symbol U-A-V-S. Now, as we can see on the website of Parrot, drones could actually be used for many different types of inspection. For example, as you can see over here, you've got search and rescue. So someone or something is lost and you put a drone in the air and then you search for the person or you search for the object. Then you've got military defense. So that's kind of what we talked about just a few minutes ago, like military surveillance and gathering intelligence, things like that. If we scroll a little bit down, we can see also law enforcement. So maybe like a hostage situation going on and you want to see what the situation looks like, how many people have been taken hostage, how many bad guys are out there, right? You've got many other types of inspection. As we can see, we've got building inspection, power line inspection, solar panel inspection, tower inspection, fire inspection, public safety, volcanoes, because why not? Volcano, sure. Work sites inspection and wildlife inspection. And if we then look at Ag Eagle, then you can see that drones could also be used for agricultural inspection as well, right? So to check, for example, how healthy their crops are and many other different things. And there are probably many more types of inspection that you could actually think about. So yeah, I think that the inspection world, the inspection sector is actually a very big use case that I could start to see a very big potential, a very big like total addressable market. And then the last one, the last application would be package delivery. And this is definitely the use case that I personally am most bullish about so far. I think that the total addressable market is just huge here, and there are many different drone companies that are looking into this segment. For example, you've got Drone Delivery Canada, which is this company over here. They have ticker symbol FLT or even TAKOF. Then you also have a company called Workhorse with ticker symbol WKHS. And of course, Amazon with ticker symbol AMZN. And yeah, of course, well, people are buying more and more things online right now. Now we need cars and we need trucks to bring all these packages to our homes. But in the future, I'm pretty sure that we're going to see drones delivering those packages instead. Now, for example, as you can see on the website of Workhorse, for example, they work together with UPS. And here you can see how this could work in the future, because drones could fix the problem of the so-called last mile delivery, meaning that, well, the last mile of the delivery is usually the most time and cost inefficient way to deliver a package, right? Because it costs quite a lot of time for a car or a truck to go to all the different houses in a village, for example. Now with drones, you could, as we can see over here, you could take a car or a truck, in this case an electric truck even, to simply go drive the truck or the car to the middle of a village and then let multiple drones fly out with different packages all at the same time, going to different homes all at the same time as well. Now this is a very cheap way and it's going to also cost you, or save you rather, a lot of time instead. Because, yeah, Workhorse is very interesting because it can provide both the electric trucks, the one you can see in the image right here, and also the drones, as you can see in the image right here. Also, if you, well, probably you can't really read this, but right here it says that this video is from 2017. So in 3 years' time, we actually haven't really seen many drones being used in the real world just yet. But personally, I'm pretty sure that is going to change within like the next 5 years, I would say. And if we then go to the website of Amazon, we can see that they are also looking into drone delivery. They state, for example, that their packages could actually be delivered within 30 minutes after ordering something online. So there you go, drones. For me personally, this is definitely one of the most exciting industries to invest in during this decade. And that is mainly because there are so many different use cases for drones, right? We've looked at the passenger transportation, looked at military use, we've looked also at inspection use cases, and of course the package delivery. But the other thing is that it's very exciting as well because it looks like we are still so early. It looks like not a lot of investors are looking into drone stocks at this very moment. So my question for you today is, which of these use cases are you most bullish about? Definitely let me know in the comments. And also let me know in the comments if you know some other massive use case that I haven't addressed in this video. And again, if you would like to stay up to date with drone stocks, and also if you would like daily stock news within 1 minute, then definitely don't forget to subscribe. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Stay safe. Bye-bye.